ever heard of a story of a woman single-handedly killing a powerful army commander? Oh, you haven't? Well, stay tuned. Welcome to Beard Ministry. My name is Josh Nichols, and this is Monday Minute. Monday Minute is a place where we get your week started off with a quick Bible study. So if you're new here, go check out some of the previous videos. But if you've been here before, you know what time it is, and it's time to get your week started off with some of that Old Testament good. Come on! Let's get started. In the last episode, we talked about Deborah and her influence of being a judge of Israel. If you haven't watched that, go back and watch it so that this video will make sense. Now, maybe you caught this little nugget from last week, but if you haven't, let's refresh your memory, okay? Deborah agrees to go with him, but says because of this, you will not get the honor of defeating Sisera. But instead, Sisera will be defeated at the hands of a woman. Now, you might think of this woman as described might be Deborah, but it wasn't, so let's dig into this story further. Continuing from the last episode, we see that Deborah and Barak, they are leading their army into battle. And we see that they defeated the entire army except for Sisera because he had escaped. He ran away on foot and escaped. After running away, we see that Sisera actually ends up at the tent of Jael. Jael tells Sisera, you know, just come on in, don't be afraid. And she ends up hiding Sisera under a blanket, and also she provides him something to drink. Yeah, he's probably thirsty from running away scared from battle. Sisera asks her to go stand at the door, and if anyone comes asking, is anyone here, tell him, you know, nobody's here. We actually see that Sisera then falls asleep because he's exhausted from running like a scaredy cat. And while he is sleeping, we see that Jael actually comes. She brings a tent peg, she puts it up to the temple of his head, and she drives it through his head, killing him. Now, while this might seem gruesome, we need to remember that King Jamin and Sisera actually kept the Israelites under oppression for 20 years. So
these aren't good people at all.
After this, the Israelites, God's chosen people, were actually able to overthrow King Jabin of Canaan. And this actually fulfills Deborah's prophecy, where because of Barak's timidness, Sisera was actually defeated by the hands of a woman, and that woman was Jael. And we see Jael's story actually honored in Judges chapter 5 by Deborah and Barak. Thank you for joining this week's Monday Minute. I hope you enjoyed it, and I would love to hear from you. What do you think about the story of Deborah and Jael? Let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget to tune in next week. We're going to continue with the story of Delilah. So until then, I encourage you to get out there and make a positive impact in someone's life today. Come on, peace.